Yeah, don't know. Yeah.
Right, Aki Kareem, BBTV. I am delighted to be joined by Mark Heffron this morning, eating some Doritos for breakfast. Is that right?
I've not opened them yet, but I was just messing around then.
Well, you know, you deserve them because you come off a really good performance at the weekend. Yeah. I got in nice and early to watch you. You know, you thought it was going to go a few rounds. Yeah. The guy had some track record, but really, you blew him away, didn't you?
That's it, yeah. Well, like I said before, I thought it was going to at least 3 or 4 rounds, maybe 5 rounds after watching his fights back. He's been in with some good lads. He's done like five or some 10-round fights against good lads that have had a big knockout ratios. And he's took them all the distance and stuff. And yeah, so I just thought I was going to get a good few rounds with him, but straight away from round one, as soon as I caught him, his legs went. And then I grabbed out of both hands and I got him out of there.
Yeah, you've always been a good finisher, but yeah, you were on him, weren't you? And I seen one shot, it was a nice short left hook, which really did the damage, and he sort of like his shoulder dropped, and the ref had to pop it, didn't he?
Yeah, that's it, mate. The ref was in there, he seen how hurt it was, and he jumped straight in.
Now, kind of a little bit of a statement, really, because you're going from strength to strength at the minute. Your performance is just, they're out of the park at the minute, aren't they, mate?
Yeah, of course, mate. We've been coming back up to super middleweight. I'm not killing myself now, boiling myself down to 11 stone 6. It was a killer getting down to that weight. But me mentally, because I knew I could do it, and I always felt like we've been going up a weight. So I always felt like I was cheating myself. Do you know what I mean? So I've always had that kind of mentality. Do you know what I mean? Because I always want to put 100% in. So obviously my manager Kevin Marie, my trainer Joe, they said that I need to come back up to super middleweight. And so obviously I made the changes and it's paying off for me now.
Oh yeah, it seems to be paying off. I mean, is this a close back-to-back fights as well, really, isn't it? So is this the most active you've been in a short space of time? Or is it back to the old days anyway?
Yeah, of course, mate. I want to be active. I want to stay busy because that's when I'm at my best. Frank's kept me busy, manager Kevin. That's how I want to keep it.
Now, that begs the question, because if you get to stay in this active, it begs the question. You're in good form at the minute. So, you know, it's perfect timing for the next one to be a substantial fight. I mean, I don't know the game plan, but can you tell us what's lined up roughly?
I've not got anything lined up at the minute. There has been talks of me going on the... If Tyson Fury's fight does go ahead, there's talks of that. Not showing the opponent. But I just want to stay active.
Well, actually, I was there. I was there recording it when Tyson came into the ring to congratulate you. What was that then? So was that sort of like pre-arranged, or did he just decide, you know what, because you go back a while, he's going to get in there?
Obviously at the end of the fight. See, when I got into the ring, I just looked out, just being curious. Like I looked out and I clocked in there, and he put his hand up to me. I was like, yeah, straight away. I thought, I'm going to get him in at the end of this. And as soon as the fight was over, I went over to him in the ring and said, come on, Tyson, jump in, let's get a picture. And I thought he was going to walk around, he just stepped over everything and jumped straight in, yeah. But I'm very thankful for him for that. And for Grant Pingy, mate, saying well done on that. I'm buzzing.
I think he did that before, would you? Once, didn't he, before?
Was it Ambrose? Yeah, Leeds.
The Josh Warrington Selby undercard.
Yeah.
There you go, mate. You're mixing with the big boys there. But I mean, you're in a gym where you get a load of people coming into it anyway for sparring, and you know it's quite a well-renowned gym. Do you get people coming in sometimes that you think, wow, this person's come in, like I can really sort of just sit there and watch them and learn a bit from them?
Oh yeah, that's the best thing about one of the best things about being at Gallagher's. I'm around numerous champions as it is. Do you know what I mean? And then obviously when Natasha Jonas is sparring and Paul Butler and Charlie was. They have to have really good kids to be sparring. So when they've got good lads coming down, you're watching good 50-50 spars all the time. So it's mint, yeah, just watching and learning. That's one thing I'm good at, me, like watching and like soaking things up. I'm like a sponge, you know what I mean? I just love it. I just want to improve and keep improving.
You know, after the Williams fight, sorry to go back to that fight, but people...
Yeah, no worries.
People were thinking, you know, oh, has Mark found his level? Has he found his level? But since then, it's the new form and like the way you're at. People are reassessing Mark Heffron. People are saying, you know what? This is like the second coming of Mark Heffron. It's a completely different version of him.
Well, it takes defeats to learn, doesn't it? Do you know what I mean? So it's the worst way to learn. But yeah, since losing to Williams and that, and to be honest, back then I remember I was getting messages up at like loads of messages like laughing at me saying, "Ah, you got beat off Liam Williams." 1 minute. Can you see me?
Yeah,
saying, you got beat off Liam Williams. You're not going nowhere. You got beat off a British level fighter. Just all those stupid messages like that. Do you know what I mean? But obviously, Williams is above British level. Do you know what I mean? He's world level, isn't it? So yeah, look, obviously, I didn't let him get to me. I just kept training hard and working hard and kept grinding it out, and I finally got there. Now, which took time, but I just kept my head down and kept going.
Well, there's certainly no shame in losing someone like Liam Williams. I mean, look, he went for Andrade, one of the best in the division, but not the best at the time in that particular division. So, but since then, Mark, I mean, you mentioned there you had some sort of messages and all that. There's a load of daffness on social media, isn't there, these days?
So people
just send, message you and tag you in daffness.
Pardon?
I was going to say, how do you handle it, mate? How do you handle that?
Can you hear me, mate?
Yeah.
I try not to read into it all too much. I just try and not read into it. And just, if I do read anything, I just try not to let it get to me.
Yeah. That's a good sensible tip, mate. Because there's a lot of fighters coming through who's not at the position you're at, who are just getting used to this, and they're thinking, "Wow!" And
keyboard warriors.
Mm. Yeah.
That's what they do for a living, isn't it?
It's true, mate. But that also is part of you're talking to me about, you've got mentally stronger, you're feeling better and everything. You learn to deal with that through like experiencing the game, don't you, I suppose?
Yeah. That's it, mate, yeah.
Now, tell me about that short left hook you threw there, because we're used to seeing that booming right hand come through, but you had that beautiful little short left hook working.
Well, I lined it up. We had like a bit of a short camp to work on this guy, but obviously, Joe's just saying come up and down. When you come down, he'll drop his hands. So obviously, I think I come down and he's dropping, and then I can't remember if I faded down or I come down. And when I dropped down, I've dropped down, he drops his hand to block the shot in it, and then I just chopped him with the left hook. And it landed perfect on the temple. So it's like probably one of the worst places you can get hit on the temple. It just dazzles your full body, doesn't it? When it landed, I threw it. Short right hand as well. The referee jumped straight in. He didn't want to see no more.
What did Joe, Scott, Crawler, everyone, Natasha, what did they all think of the performance and what do they think of this new version of Mark?
I've not spoken to Natasha and Crawler yet, but Quigg and Joe, they was buzzing. Joe's more happy because I'm listening. Do you know what I mean? I'm taking it all in.
Yeah. And you are, mate. And you know what? Like, how far off your peak do you think you are? Do you think you're getting right into your peak now?
I won't say I was far off, but I got off my performances when I fight, like inspiring, like when I start taking it into the ring on fight, like what I'm doing inspiring, you'll all be surprised because there's still a lot more to show you.
What sort of stuff, mate? What sort of stuff? Because I know you don't want to give too much away, but like what sort of stuff have you been developing on specifically in the last 6 months or whatever?
Just everything, really, just all around everything. Like my defense, my boxing skills, my jab, just everything. Literally everything you can improve on in the boxing. And like I said, it's just being around all the other champions in the gym. It's just improving me massively and watching them. Like I said, I'm always picking things up and watching them.
Now, when you actually get in the ring now, then are you just like brimming with confidence because you look like you are? And that was always something where you got a bit of pre-fight nerves, but now it just looks like you're absolutely brimming with confidence when you get in there.
Yeah, I'm happy to be in there. Like I used to like struggle with nerves and stuff like that, and now I'm just happy to be in there and I'm enjoying it. Yeah, I've been working with a lad called Brian Brewis. He's been helping me out massively with all that side of the boxing, and he's been a massive help, and I'm very thankful to him. And he's been helping me out massively.
Well, look, it's great to see you going in the way you're going, and it looks like knocking on the door for another good title fight. And in the meantime, we're enjoying the ride, mate.
That's it. Yeah. Well, there's been talks of Kevin Sadjo for the European. I don't know where they're up to with that, but So it's a very, very tough fight, but I think I'm capable of beating him. So I'm not sure where Kevin and Frank are up to with that, but so that's a fight I would be happy with. Like I say, it's not going to be an easy one, but I think I've got the skills to beat him.
That would be a great fight, mate. That would be a great fight.
Yeah.
And domestically, is there anything that takes your fancy domestically? I mean, people are sort of tagging you into things to do with like Jack Cullen, for example. People
yeah.
like that. What would you think about the sort of domestic fights?
100%, mate. I'll fight any of them. Jack Cullen, any of them. Yeah, I'm up for any of them guys.
I mean, one thing about you is it's always entertainment.
Yeah.
You've never been in a dull fight, have you?
Nah. There's another thing as well. Like, I've never shied away from a fight. Three's got my box record. Like, I've never shied away from a fight or fight anyone. Do you know what I mean? And obviously, that's what I got Kevin on board for. He sorts all that side of the box now. So it's really me saying, yeah, Kevin has to be happy with whatever I want to do as well. And,
yeah. You're old school, mate, aren't you? You get told who to fight and you just turn up.
That's it, mate. That's it. You're not in boxing to shy away from any fights, isn't it?
I don't think anyone can say that you dodge opponents. I mean,
no.
You know, if you look at it, especially with like the Liam Williams fight, you know, you said yourself before that you probably hadn't had enough experience in the game, but you didn't dodge it. You met it head on, didn't you?
Definitely, mate. Even Denzel Bentley fight, like,
yeah.
Before I boxed him, he had something silly like record knocking everybody out. And as soon as they offered that to me, I jumped out and got it with both hands. Denzel Bentley's a good fighter as well. I had two good fights with him there. I'm just looking to keep moving forward now.
Yeah, brilliant. Yeah, I forgot about Bentley. I mean, of course he was unbeaten, I think, when he fought you the first time. And that was good fight. And a lot of people think you won that fight, you know.
Yeah.
Brilliant, mate. It's going well for you. And I got in nice and early to watch you. And even though it was early, you still bought your massive crowd from all
over. Yeah.
So anything to say to them?
Just a massive thank you. And you know how thankful I am. I'm always, no matter how many messages I get out, the thousands, I get hundreds and thousands of messages. And I text time, but I always get back to everybody and tell them how thankful I am. And I'm very thankful to them all. And from sticking with us, and I'm very thankful.
Brilliant, Mark. Well, looking forward to the next update of your career. Best of congratulations to you, Kev, Joe, Quig, the whole full team.
Yeah.
And looking forward to doing this again in the build-up to your next
Thank
fight.
Thank you very much, Jackie. Thank you.
Top man. Cheers,
Top
mate.
Man. Very much, mate. Nice one.